The long-awaited stable Diffusion SDXL has been finally released. Be sure to watch until the end, because in this video I will also explain how to run SDXL on your own without waiting in a Clipdrop QI using my Google Colab notebook. And yes, I also added the official VRE. Now let's get back to the release. What's new in SDXL? The first and most obvious change is the high resolution. Instead of 512 by 512, it's now 1024 by 1024. It's 4 times larger. On the whole, SDXL generates images considered to the best in overall quality and are aesthetic across a variety of styles and concepts. Shorter prompts. SDXL understands short prompts much better than the previous models. You don't need lengthy walls of text for prompts to get the desired result. More accurate understanding of prompts. Prompting in SDXL not only simple, but more true to the intention of prompts. SDXL's improved clip model understands text so effectively that concepts like the red square are understood to be different from a red square. That was an official statement, and I tested out this specific prompt. Yes, you can see some difference, but Stable Diffusion SDXL still thinks that a red square and the red square are the same concepts. High flexibility of Stable Diffusion. SDXL is prime for complex image design workflow that include generation for text or base image, in painting with mask, outpainting, and more. SDXL can also be fine-tuned for concepts and use with control nets. Some of these features are planned for future releases of Stability AI. Better human anatomy. I've already seen some examples from CVTA, so it probably depends on personal preference. But speaking seriously, previous SD models had visual problems with generating correct human anatomy. They often had extra of missing limbs, extremely deformed faces, etc. Stable Diffusion SDXL partially addresses these issues. Better text handling. SDXL might produce more readable text, which is a traditional problem for diffusion models. I tested out, and yes, now it looks way more better, but still is not perfect. Artistic styles. These don't make SDXL directly better, but they are somewhat different. Stable Diffusion SDXL offers several artistic styles for image generation. They are no style, as base, enhance, anime, photographic, digital art, comic book, fantasy art, analog film, neon punk, isometric, low poly, origami, line art, and pixel art, and a lot more. Improved composition. Enhanced images composition allows for creating stunning visuals for almost any type of prompts without too much hassle. Stable Diffusion SDXL license is the same as the previous one, SD1.5. This means that it's absolutely free for commercial use. Stable Swarm UI and Alpha focus on multi-GPU support. For those who missed the anatomy part for some reason, SDXL can still generate not safe for work content. What is I suppose overall good for Stable Diffusion community. SDXL is easier to tune, and model will include additional metadata, and it will be easy to manage them. Already some issues have arisen. Some users from Reddit have reported artifact in the generated images, which is likely due to a problem with VRE. Nevertheless, this doesn't seem to be a serious issue. In my few tests, I haven't encountered everything similar. Everything was perfect. However, it's the best if you check it out for yourself. So let's move to the part where you can test SDXL by yourself with just one click using my Google Colab notebook, which I made special for you. As usual, open Google Colab notebook using my link, which I leave in the description under this video. Then just run only one this cell, that's it, by pressing this button. Now we are installing our requirement, then downloading both base Excel model and official VRE and running our ComfyUI consequently. This was all you had to do. Just wait about 4 minutes until all process will be finished. Here we go, we've got our URL. Just follow this link. And then we need to copy the IP address and then paste it here and click to submit. Here we go. I already talked about ComfyUI, but to start using it, you just need to know a few things. Firstly, enter the prompt and negative prompt in these two nodes. That's it. Then here you can change resolution. And don't forget to use base resolution for this model, which is 1024 by 1024. You can adjust sampler settings in this section, almost the same like it works in the automatic 1111. If something goes wrong or the canvas is disturbed, simply click load default. Here. That's it. But don't forget to enter base resolution. Let's try some prompt and query prompt in order to get our result. And here's the result. Everything is working fine. Great. Don't forget to close your session in a Google Colab notebook. Thanks for watching. If you find this video helpful, let me know it by pressing like button and write your thought about new release. Bye-bye.